Hello and welcome to Sore Month. So, we come to know some horror films, a lot of horror films, have stupid decisions in them. Stupid characters, stupid decisions, stupid mistakes. Horror films are saturated, completely crowded with them. What about the Saw franchise? So this is another WatchMojo video. This is the top 10 worst decisions in Saw. I think this will be interesting to look at. because there are a lot of dumb decisions being made in the franchise. So, but it'll be interesting to see what they rank as the stupidest one. So, let's begin.
Some people are just bad at playing games. Welcome nice to Watch pun. Mojo, and today we'll be counting down our picks for the top 10 worst decisions in Saw. For this list, we'll be looking at poor choices made by characters in the Saw franchise. These picks all deal with dire moments throughout the Saw movies, so a spoiler alert is in order. Number 10. Ryan opens a door marked No Exit, Jigsaw. Ryan is sealed with Mitch and Anna in one of Jigsaw's trap buildings.
Ryan was actually my favorite character in Jigsaw.
I have no idea.
He tries to use an exit to get out early and ends up catching his leg in an intricate wire setup.
Oh yeah, this.
While trying to open a door isn't inherently a bad idea, Ryan's choice to open one marked No Exit is questionable at best.
No! For real, you don't think he's trying to tell us something?
Yeah, he is.
This is particularly upsetting considering that by this point, Ryan is already well aware of how lethal Jigsaw's games are. His failure to remind Anna about the literal nature of these traps are what ultimately seals his fate. But his failure to follow basic directions remains more frustrating. Jigsaw's punishments are all about teaching people, and Ryan demonstrates the pitfalls of learning nothing. Number 9.
Yeah,
Gus looks through
that
the
one's horrible.
Saw 2.
I remember this.
In this gory sequel, a group of strangers wake up in a room and soon learn that they've been poisoned.
Right now, you are breathing in a deadly nerve agent. You've been breathing it since you arrived here. Those of you familiar with the Tokyo subway attacks will know its devastating effects on the human body.
Understandably distraught and driven by panic, Xavier commits to using a key on the door. Despite a note telling them explicitly not to.
No, that's not a good idea.
Yeah, don't do that.
This idea is already risky considering the warning, but Gus putting his eye to the people simultaneously is downright stupid. All the previous mentions of noises behind the door only serve to prove how little Gus listens. Though Xavier triggers this trap, Gus's plan to back him up is the mistake.
The narration recording is really weird on this one.
Number 8. Gordon forgets the saw. Saw. Adam and Lawrence's confinement makes up the central tension of Saw, with the two men struggling to find a way out. Unfortunately, armed with little more than a bone saw and a one-way cell phone, the pair quickly find themselves devolving into panic. When Lawrence can't reach the phone later in the film, he naively gives up without trying other options. The fact he doesn't extend his reach with the saw is painful to watch, especially as he uses it elsewhere only seconds later. It's also unclear why Adam doesn't give this advice. Even if the saw somehow slipped their minds, it's similarly disheartening that Lawrence doesn't think to use his shirt to extend his reach before employing it as a tourniquet.
I didn't even think of that, to be honest. And I was kind of just like, oh yeah, he could have done.
Number 7. Rig gets too eager. Saw 4. By the time Officer Rigg became a protagonist in Saw 4, he'd already played a supporting role against Jigsaw in two previous films. Jigsaw tested him in this installment by telling him that his need to save others went too far.
But with your survival came your obsession. Obsession to stop those around you from making the wrong choices, thus preventing you from making the right ones. You wanted to save everyone. Tonight, I give you the opportunity to face your obsession.
Regardless of these warnings, Rig rushed to Brenda's aid, and wouldn't you know it, he wound up setting off otherwise avoidable timers. Given Jigsaw's hints, you'd think he could have looked around first and discovered the trap before touching things. Rig had already led his fellow policemen to harm in Saw 2 by being rash, and yet still ran hastily into his
final test 2
movies later.
I forgot about that as well.
Number 6. Eric attacks Amanda. Saw 3. Detective Eric Matthews' quest to stop Jigsaw ultimately saw him trapped in the room from the original Saw. He surprised Amanda by escaping so quickly, but his move to fight her was poorly planned. Matthew was already at a disadvantage with his broken foot.
I was going to say.
He shouldn't have started a brawl.
Like, that was a mistake. That was a huge mistake.
While he was lucky to be left alive to crawl home, his decision to taunt Amanda further was arguably his most self-destructive idea of all.
Where's my son?
Considering how few people have survived Jigsaw's traps, Matthew's confrontational attitude was a terrible way to approach things.
Yeah, he could have just gone.
Never working together. Saw 5.
In choosing how to react to this situation, your lifelong instincts will tell you to do one thing, but I implore you to do the opposite. Let the games begin.
5 people are tested with a series of traps in Saw 5. Unfortunately, each person fends for themselves when they're tethered together, rather than attempting to use one key to free everyone.
And that's what he was saying.
They bizarrely miss the fact that another's room's safe zones can hold multiple people.
So, yeah, that's what he was saying. Like, he's saying, oh, you'll all do one thing, but I implore you to do the opposite. Like, they all look out for themselves, but he's asking them to work together. Like, that was the whole point of Saw 5. Which I quite liked. I get why people found it boring, but I quite liked that whole thing. Because it wasn't until the end, it was kind of like a light bulb moment. It was like, oh, you guys are screwed. There's nothing that you can do now.
Which needlessly diminishes their numbers further.
Better luck next time, rich boy.
This British guy,
in
you never
end,
find out what he actually did.
Mean that their final trials involving shocks and violent sacrifices are all the more severe.
So one person can fill the beaker with 10 pints of blood and die.
Yeah.
But 2 people can fill it with 5 pints.
All this stumbling is even less excusable since Jigsaw tells them from the start that they're specifically being punished for selfish actions.
That's what I just said.
The whole set of traps is surprisingly easy in retrospect. If only these victims had actually worked together
exactly.
on each one.
Exactly. That's what I just said.
So are you.
We both deserve to be here.
Number 4. Adam tries to shoot Jigsaw. Saw. Right as Lawrence left the bathroom and Saw, we see the real Jigsaw rise in front of Adam. When Jigsaw tells Adam that the key to his chain is in the bathtub, Adam remembers having pulled the plug. Meaning the key is gone.
I would have said that was the worst decision.
Instead of feeling Jigsaw's sense of fair play or trying to shoot the chains, he decides to shoot Jigsaw. His impulsive last-ditch effort makes no sense. Even if he killed Jigsaw, it wouldn't have solved anything. He'd still have been trapped. In response, Jigsaw electrocutes Adam and leaves him to die.
I don't know. I would have put the plug hole thing as the worst decision.
Hands in the box. Saw 2.
Oh,
yeah, definitely.
We in jail?
Nah. This ain't jail, man.
Yeah, you done a lot of time?
Yeah. Too much.
From the start of her imprisonment in Saw 2, Addison maintains a level-headed attitude to exploring the house. After being weakened by poison for hours, she finds a box with an antidote in it. However, she ignores the mini-cassette, then accidentally spills a liquid from the syringe. With her one hand caught in blades, it's unclear why she doesn't try to free herself with the other one. Her decision to put another hand in the box is foolish to the point of being fatal.
I think if you can see the key behind the box as well, or the top of the frame.
Puzzles is agonizingly bad. Number
2. Oh well.
Peter doesn't listen. Saw 5. Peter Strom chases down Jigsaw for some time, and even survives a trap in a search for the truth. When he finds a glass coffin sitting in a room, he starts playing a tape that gives a compelling argument to get in.
The only way to survive this room is by entering the glass box before you. Pain will be incurred, but you have a chance of survival.
Peter stops the tape mid-sentence to hide, however, and forces the sinister Detective Hoffman into the case.
Hoffman gave you an opportunity to survive.
Information, Peter dooms himself to the closing walls of the room. The fact that he doesn't finish the tape before using the trap is truly disappointing.
Yeah, because it's the one time he was like, oh, I can...
To trust me.
Regardless of Peter's understandable mistrust of Hoffman, he sadly loses his game because he can't follow instructions.
I know who you are! I know!
It doesn't matter.
Continue. Be sure to subscribe to our channel and ring the bell to get notified about our latest videos. You have the option to be notified for occasional videos or all of them. If you're on your phone, make sure you go into your settings and switch on notifications.
Number 1. Jeff gloats and takes too long. Saw 3. The vengeful Jeff is forced into a series of traps that revolve around the death of his son and the ensuing court case.
That's just Saw 3 in a nutshell.
The people he blames for the outcome. While these mixed emotions make sense, his inevitable shift to help everyone renders his delays frustratingly counterproductive. Jeff's angry shaming of each person is also stupidly wasteful, given how dire their situations are already.
You don't remember me. Well, maybe you remember Timothy Young?
By taking so long, most people are beyond saving by the time Jeff decides to help. All his bumbling decision-making ultimately hurts him the most, and cements his trials as being among the franchise's most difficult to watch.
Do you agree with our picks? Check out this other recent clip from WatchMojo, and be sure to subscribe and ring the bell to be notified about our latest videos.
I think that's it. I reckon I actually agree with the number one, to be honest. That number one pick is just Saw 3 in a nutshell. Like, I get it at the same time because of his situation. But, I don't know, by the fourth sort of room you've gone into, wouldn't you have kind of realised that you'd have to push past that and move on? I don't know. I kind of get why that's number one, but I'm just like, at the same time, I get his situation as well. But yeah, Jeff gloats and takes too long. That's just Saw 3 in a nutshell. That is literally Saw 3 in a nutshell. Allison with the box trap thing. It's probably the most famous worst decision in the Saw franchise. It's referenced so much, and while it's stupid, again, I can kind of defend it with that. They even say, like, after hours of her having the poison in her blood, it's kind of messed up her mind. It's still stupid, but it makes a bit more sense as to why she doesn't really think about things. Also, if you can see in the top frame as well, there is the key behind the box. So if she had just stopped and thought about what was actually going on in front of her, she would have been able to solve it. Decision of Adam shooting Jigsaw. Again, I don't know, this is all kind of stuff where I'm like, okay, I get why you picked that, but I don't agree kind of thing. Or I played devil's advocate to defend it. But with this one, I would have actually picked the very first shot we see of the film, which is Adam has his toes tangled round the plug hole, and he pulls the plug out of the bath, and his key goes down the drain. Literally, it's the first thing we see in the first film. I personally would have put that, because this is worse decisions, and not necessarily worse as stupid, but it could also be worse as in, oh no, you've doomed yourself, basically. So I think that could have qualified as well. I don't really know if there's anything else actually I want to mention with this one. I've kind of mentioned a couple of them, so like the Saw 5 trap where they had to work together. I like that because it's not something you really think about, because you're viewing the traps in their eyes, so you're thinking, okay, well, yeah, each person has to be kicked off for them to get through this room. And it isn't until you get to the end with those five cubes that they got to put their hand through. It's like, oh, I wasn't thinking either. So it's not like, it doesn't make the viewer feel stupid, but it puts you in the victim's shoes and minds, which I quite like. I mean, yeah, I get why people don't like Saw 5. It is a bit boring and a bit confusing, but I don't know. I think I like that side of it, like the main trap sequences. I don't really have much else to say with this one, actually. It was pretty sort of self-explanatory, to be honest. But it's interesting to see what WatchMojo was going to put as their number one, what they weren't going to include. To be honest, a lot of it, I can't actually think of anything else that I would have included, actually, to be honest, apart from the ones I've mentioned. So this was WatchMojo's top 10 worst decisions in Saw. Thank you all for watching, and I will see you all soon.